So what the hell's going on? Got this Parker. Oh, she's sick. She's a sick puppy. We're gonna fix her up. So the poor thing, I don't know what happened to it. I think, the more I look at this, this was maybe in a very warm environment. It's very, very tight. It even twisted the plastic pick guard, which is like, today's plastics don't do that. So something happened. It got really, really tight. The neck's got a back bow. And everything else works. It's got one of this super overhead torque ram corduzel piezoelectric, you know, I don't know, skyrocket switch. There's a little piezo thing in every saddle. So these are a little finicky, to say the least. It's all, there's a little wire off of every one of these guys. And I guess if I can't flatten out the pick guard, it sort of sails pretty good without, you know, except for the shitty marks where that was. But that might actually, I don't know how it got so tight. Like, what would warp the plastic? It's got, had to be like heat, like a trunk or the back seat of a car or a store window, because there's no fret wear on it at all, really. So it doesn't look like a player. But it's got sharp fret ends too. So it's really, really shrunk-a-doodle-dood. Okay, let the games begin. Yeah, so the adjustment for the truss rod is dead loose. It's doing 5/8 of screw all. That's a spoke nut, in case anybody knows what that stupid thing's actually called. So, and the neck is still back bowed. I'm gonna have a look down it again. So what I gotta do is that wonderful clamping thing that I did before, but we're gonna do it in reverse, right? Because the other one was bowed severely that way. This one is this way, so you'll see. But you know, I really sort of dig that without the black pick guard on it, but that poor thing, I don't know. I'll maybe show you. I'm just going to clamp it flat for a while, and I'll show you a little trick. We'll do something with a heat gun, and hopefully fix that up too. But we can only do the best we can do. Perfection is for Allah. And while we're bitching about stuff, I know that's probably a really cool spot to put that switch, like, so you can get it. But you know what? They make one that's got, like, half of that thing sticking out, so your shirt doesn't get freaking caught on it and busted. But that's just me, because I'm just, you know, bitching. But, like I said, they make one with a tiny little, like, half of this. You know, low profile, I guess you'd say. She's pretty to the deck. Okay, time to dismember. But that's a hell of a balanced design. The only other guitar I've ever seen do that's a Les Paul. That's pretty good. But she's got a couple kadingers, a couple injuries there. So we'll try and spit that up too, I guess. Okay, let's take the neck off of a Parker. So without the string tension, the neck's probably going to want to go even more like Gordie Howe's hockey stick. So I'm going to get her clamped up tonight. And we'll leave it overnight. And, you know, tomorrow it'll be all better. So we pop the neck off and we find the factory shim. Why do they always use a piece of sandpaper? Paper compresses. This is not a shim material. Paper is not, anything that compresses is not for a shim. What the frickin' hell? Okay, so it's whipped up. This is loose. Look, I can spin it with my finger. So we got to fix that. That's where the magical sequence of building blocks come into place. I know they look like shit on a shingle, but I'm going to show you a little magic here. The reason they're all different sizes is to do different things. So stand by and watch this. Okay, so he goes there. That guy, oh, well, he could work maybe in two directions. We can put him under there, like that. And it doesn't quite work out very well, so we're going to flip him over. And we don't really need any protection here, because that's the part that goes in the guitar you don't see. And that's there, and I'm going to pull this to the very edge of the bench. Focus please camera, and then I'm going to pull out a big clamp and we're going to yank this down towards planet Earth. So I'm going to use this big clamp to force this down. Woohoo! Notice it's all the same old belt that I used. I bought one belt, an old leather belt from the store, and made all this shit out of it. So now what I've done with a little mechanical help is I've forced it into the reverse situation, and now we'll tighten this up as much as I can. So what we're doing is assisting this and forcing it mechanically, and I'm choking and croaking. I said this in a couple other videos. If you can't spin this thing, you know, with a wrench easily, then you need to help the neck into straightness. And this is not a ridiculous thing to do, but this is something that has to get done sometimes. So this guitar will be great. It's like that the other one I fixed for my friend George. It's the same thing. We had to clamp the shit out of it, and it's going to be okay. I can feel the truss rod resisting the clamp. Getting real tight, like a summon of a bitch. Oh yeah, honey, I love it. Okay, so hopefully tomorrow when I pop this apart, the neck is gonna stay where I just put it mechanically, and then I can actually use the truss rod again, because when I back it off, it's going to relax the neck and it'll make it straight. But frets are in great shape on this. They look pretty really decent. The only other thing is it's shrunk so much, there's sharp fret ends, and I'll try and get a really good video of me correcting that. It's ugly as hell. It's just like watching a doctor cut your arm open. You don't want to see it, but I'm going to show you anyway, and then you'll go, oh, I don't want to, don't do that to my guitar, but I'm fixing it, but don't do it, yeah, but I'm making you, but don't. Another add-on to the, don't try this at home, okay, unless you're like, don't give a shit, or have really tried. So, you see, she's all warped up, this old pickguard. So I got her clamped to the bench, one screw to the bench. I'm going to gently heat this like a flapjack until it's all sort of soft and it's going to fall flat. Then I'm going to screw it down to the bench flat and we're going to leave it and let it get stiff again. Did I say get stiff again? Don't tell my wife. Yeah, if it burns your hand, well, it's gonna burn your fucking pickguard. So, like, it took nothing to make that thing fall flat. Like, but I want to make it really warm. And then I'm gonna screw it to the flat bench. Magic. One more time with the heat machine. And then I'm gonna put this big ugly sucker on it. Not the beer, that's my last beer too. So that means I have to go to bed now. Beer's over. I've wrecked enough stuff for today. Okay, so clamped in reverse to the bench and some heat gun action and another clamp and the twisted neck clamped backwards on the bench till tomorrow, and I've sort of had enough. Cheers. It's the morning after, the night before. And today I'm working on these guitars. Tomorrow we're back to movie making bullshit. Okay, so let's pull out the screws and see if I got this to flatten out a bit. Well, I think we had some great success. Let's try it on the guitar body and see if it lays flat. Okay, so the pickguard's gonna be okay. Before it was so whipped, it was like above the pickup. But I don't know if the camera can get this. There's an alignment problem with the screw holes, so I'm gonna have to tweak those a bit to make it to sit where it should, because I don't know. I'm gonna talk to George. See if I like the way it rolls with the pickguard off it. I got no problem with that. Anyways, crap. Okay, so that's that part. At least we straightened out the plastic. You saw how I did that. Be careful if you want to try that kind of crap. Now there's this part of this puzzle here, so let's release the clamp and see if we were able to straighten out the neck. It should all work great. Now, releasing the unbelievable amount of truss rod tension that I put on this thing. I don't know. Well, it's straighter, but
No dice. Shitty.
Okay, we can understand what's gone wrong here. I think the neck's a little green, and where the biggest part of the back bow is where it's been grafted together out of two pieces of maple. I don't know if that, I'm hoping the camera's getting that. So, the two pieces have obviously changed in a different manner. I wonder why, because it's two different pieces of wood. So I got to put the clamp back on it, and it's all right here, right where the two join together. That's where it's got a big goofy back bow. Alrighty, back on the rack. Today's shish kebab will be a Parker. So these are great, the little tapered ends. And we're going to use a little bit of white glue. Like that. Glue those in. And then I'll come back with Japanese saw. They won't be sending us many of these for a while. Flush cut. Slice them off. Wish me luck. So I get to leave that for a couple hours. I figure I'm going to leave the neck clamped for another couple hours. That'll take me into the middle of the afternoon. In the meantime, I'm going to take that little Marshall amp upstairs and grind the living hell out of it. Okay, stand by for, I think this is going to be like a part two. I still got fret ends to deal with sticking out on that. Okay. So, unlike that other neck straightening job you might have watched me do, this one is not cooperating. So what we have to do now is I have to leave this thing stuck on the bench over there, cranked in a reverse curve to the Sirius back bow, and I guess, I don't know, 72 hours, but it's got to stay there now. It didn't want to straighten out quickly, and it may just be too green, and if that's the case, then I'll have to make a suggestion to my friend about how, what we can do to hopefully pull it straight. That worked out okay. So once again, I just installed the six that lined up, and now I just gotta repilot the three that didn't line up and screw her back down, and she's all good. That half, I'm not quite sure about the neck yet. We'll find out later on. This will be part two. I'm going to leave that thing strapped to the bench for at least a couple of days before I look at it again. Okay, issue solved. I checked earlier, all the electronics, everything seems to work. One thing with these piezos things in every saddle, there's a little wire that goes down in there. So it's really tough to get in here and clean things up because of that little wire. But the pick guard's no longer warped up in the air. So that's cool. I hope I can unwarp the neck. Stay tuned for part two. Cheers.